thank you guys for letting us be here. My name is Shelley Hollis, and I work with Mississippi State University. And I also have Mr. Kenny Langley here with me today from Mississippi State University. And we both work with the Research and Curriculum Unit at the university. And primarily, we do a lot of work with the Department of Education, helping them develop curriculum that you guys use in your classes. What I'm working on right now is computer science curriculum. I'm trying to get computer science into all the schools across the state, kindergarten through 12th grade. You guys are gonna write code today. So when you leave here, you can tell, it'll tell you how many lines of code you've written, and you can go share that with your friends and your family.
I first started doing coding in fourth grade.
Today, using coding, I actually helped Elsa form a snowflake, which was very interesting.
The coding makes the video game characters walk, jump, run, do everything they do.
For the hour of code, we made games. We scripted the characters to do things and helped them throughout the journey.
This allows us to reignite the interest in computer science. And back in the day, you really had to know code. You had to know Fortran. You had to know all of these programs in order to develop something. And with the Visual Basic piece, with the drag and drop, we're showing them now that it is very easy to develop that code. I think that Mississippi can be a leader in this area. And I think that coding can be, and computer science can be, one of these ways that we can do that.
The biggest benefit we see so far in instituting computer science into our programs here at the school is the students are beginning to develop more critical thinking skills and learning how to think ahead, almost like chess, but on the computer, because whenever they want the characters in the coding to do certain things, they have to think ahead and decide what they want them to do and when they want them to do it. Coding and computer science is new to a lot of our students. Even though they have cell phones and they know how to work computers, they really don't know how to code and how it works. So it gives them an opportunity to fail and understand that I can fail at this, but I can recover from it. So we see that carrying over into other classes where it's okay to make a mistake. I can think around this mistake and develop a better answer, whether it be in math, English, social studies, or science classes, because they've had the experience because of the computer science being brand new to them.
I started coding early this year with joining the computer science PLTW Project Lead the Way class. I would like to see myself make a career in video game development with using computer science.
I use my home computer for research, homework, and different projects and things for school. In the future, I would like to use computer science to design things using CAD programs, like houses, dresses, and different things like that.
The skill level in terms of precision and attention that it takes to code, I think, is vitally important for our scholars today. You know, we are in a microwave society that thinks quick, 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 finish, finish, finish. But coding is an art that I think might replace some of the other lost arts. And, you know, just the minute attention that it takes, concentration that it takes, we know that it's building their brain power.
I'd like to get into video games and programming, making sure that they're safe for other kids to play, making sure that kids will have fun playing on them. The Sphero SPRK Plus is like a technological pet. It allows you to code it and you tell it whatever you want it to do. This thing is the best thing I've ever had because I've always wanted to program myself. And now that I have him, it's just the best thing that I've ever done.